doggy meat.
One of the things I was, you know, scouring the internet, and I just happened to come across some information of rumors for the PSVR 2.
Yeah.
Right. And so I was like super stoked about this. Right. I mean, I've known that it was, you know, in theory and whatnot, and that they were eventually going to come out with another model. But this one seems like they've already strategically made moves to put this in effect or whatever. So there's already there was already patents that were found on how the controllers were gonna be. So they're not gonna look like the PlayStation Move controllers.
Nice.
They're gonna have like nice little Quest like grip controllers.
Okay.
You know, with little straps on the handles and whatnot. The headset was gonna be wireless. So that's nice. Great. You know what I mean? That was the main issue that I had with the VR headset.
It had a big battery in that thing.
Yeah. I mean, I don't even mind allowing me to attach an external battery pack to it to give it the little extra boost, as long as it's wireless. That's all I really care about. Yeah. You know what I mean? You can buy a cheap battery pack. You need that
to really move around and really get into a game. You know?
Right,
you
right. Know? To be able to really get into the world and not have to worry about strings attached to it.
Right.
And then on top of that, you know, I was hearing that, okay, so you know how they say that the PlayStation, the PSVR headset one is compatible with the PS5. You can use it with the PS5. Mm-hmm. But I did hear that the HD camera that they have brought out, the brand new one, is not. So that's why would you come out with an HD camera and it's not good with the old VR headset?
Because
that's
camera?
Like one of the reasons why you would, you know, you would get like the new HD cameras, because, you know, it's for the headset. You know what I mean? That's one of the reasons why I wanted to get it. I was like, oh, you know, maybe this camera will be able to pick up, you know, my sensors and stuff like that a little better. So, I mean, I guess that means that it's got the same port on the PS5 as it had on the PS4 to allow you to be able to use the backwards, you know, compatible camera or whatever. But it just leads me to believe that, okay, so you made a camera that does not work with this old version of the PSVR. So you got to have a second one coming in, because who really uses the camera for like anything?
Yeah.
Like, right. I don't even think that the camera pays attention to like your facial scan when you go to sign in on your PlayStation. You know, I don't know who set that, you know, feature up. You know, it's there, but I don't know who really set it up.
Right.
So, I mean, I know you guys aren't as enthusiastic about VR as I am, but, you know, how do you guys feel about that,
like
that information?
You really like VR, right? It's not just like a gimmick to you. You really enjoy it.
No,
right?
It's dope. I mean, there's so many other games that come out that, you know, I'm playing that instead of the VR game. But when I played, you know, Walking Dead, Saints and Sinners, like the game was fun. You know what I mean? So I could be in that for, you know, hours.
And you really like the VR, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. The VR is great.
And yeah. See, I
still haven't played the Hitman, you know, to check out that VR
right.
stuff. But yeah.
For me, the problem with VR was always the price point of entry.
Yeah,
the point of entry was hardest for me.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure.
To get over that hill.
It's like buying a whole nother console.
It is. It's like buying a whole nother console. So I never really took the dive. And when we did that racing game,
with the Thrustmaster. The Thrustmaster.
Oh my
god. The Thrustmaster was the name of the containment unit that you were in to play the game. I think the game that we played was like Forza 4 or something like that.
Yeah.
But the Thrustmaster was like this full unit that you could sit in, and it would literally,
when you're in the race car.
Yeah, yeah. And it would literally like move around.
Dude,
and stuff
I was
like that.
Sick.
It was expensive.
When I got out of that ride, I was so sick, and like the motion just like had me spinning dizzy.
I didn't feel that sick.
Yeah,
I thought
it was
kind of crazy.
It was terrible.
It was cool.
Like I felt like I was like actually car sick. And that really, really turned me off of VR. But the PSVR 2 is supposed to have much improved motion sickness improvements. So that's huge for me,
because
that was one of my biggest issues Which that made me a little bit more excited.
Walking was the only thing that had effed me up. And some
you
try games, to walk,
you're like a little bit of shaky.
Like, so there was some games like Planet of the Apes. That was a great game because, you know, the aiming was really on point, but you could just move your controllers like this
to
and
walk.
Then you would propel forward. But there was games like Skyrim. I did not play Skyrim. I might have played like maybe 10 to 20 minutes of Skyrim, but I could not play it because it was just making me nauseous.
Yeah,
like,
see, that's what I'm worried about.
I had an issue with the camera receiving the direction that my move controllers was going. It would always like shake me off. And then you had another one where you could just like click the trigger on the controller and aim, and then you would teleport. But that teleport had me all effed. Like, I just couldn't deal with it. Like, I was just like, oh, I'm not going to be able to enjoy this game.
Yeah.
You know? I played, like, Blood and Truth. That was a great game. The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners. But, yeah, there was just, like,
some
Skyrim.
Some terrible,
just,
huh?
I just couldn't do it. Yeah.
Yeah, so those are the reasons why, like, I haven't really jumped in. And the PSVR 2 is making all the changes that I want.
Right.
I'm still concerned about the point of entry. I know the rumored prices was like $500 to $800 between there.
That's a lot.
I know, man. Like
$500?
$500. That was the low too, what they were speculating the price would be.
Man.
And so I was like,
I'm hoping that's like a bundle or something like that. For like, I don't know.
I don't know. I like all the changes. It's gonna have finger sensing now. So you can sense your fingers, not just like, you know, clunky controllers.
Right.
So like there's lots of really neat things, and you can do a whole lot more with the PS5. But that hardware is much more capable to put better graphics
you just still have to be able to have like a hardcore processing unit in the headset to be able to see, you know what I mean? Like it would be nice if you could see in 4K in the unit as well, or at least, you know, in
very
really
clear,
high quality.
Really clear. So I like all the changes. I like all the directions. I think it's good. I do know that I read an article and Sony said that they do not expect PSVR to take off anytime soon. And I always thought that was a major concern when they first announced the PSVR was I just didn't think that there was enough need or want for it in the market.
Uh-huh.
For something like this, as well as they did, like, because you really like it, and it's not just a gimmick; it's a very useful product that you enjoy using. And so, they did a great job with it, but they just haven't sold like they wanted. And I had a feeling that would happen. I know Oculus, all those other ones, just have fallen off on by the wayside.
Well, the Quest
the
2,
Quest
they
2.
Just released
it's
that.
New. It's all in one headset, $299.
Yeah,
and so
the
we'll
Quest,
see.
The Quest,
I know they're still trying.
A good unit. The issue isn't necessarily the actual units, you know what I mean? Like the headsets and all that stuff. That's not the issue. The problem is getting a great game to play on it. If you do not invest in any companies, no companies invest in the headset, like there's no reason for anybody to play it. Like all of these headsets, they just have like bullshit little games to play. You know what I mean? Like they're cool, they're nifty, you know what I'm saying? But they're nothing crazy. You don't get a Cyberpunk in VR.
Yeah, I don't know how to do that. Like I don't know how they can get the Ready Player One action going on, you know, where like because you can't really move around your room. You gotta kind of stand still. So the moving the arms, that's an interesting workaround. I mean, I just don't know how you would incorporate a game like Deus Ex Machina or whatever, you know. I don't know how you would do it. I think more like what was that one game we played at PlayStation Experience where we were like versing each other and you had like a board and you picked up units and you were placing them out there and you were
I know what you're talking about.
That is really a great utilization of VR, like a kind of like a stationary kind of thing where you're kind of like interacting and picking and moving things up and doing all that. Like that is a really great utilization. I thought that was the first time I was like, wow, like this is great.
Right.
But what do you do, you know, for like the big open world and, you know, action adventure games?
So there's actually lots of companies that are working on treadmills for video games.
Yeah.
And there's some that are decently priced for what they are. You know what I mean? For you to full on sprint in the middle of your living room and not go anywhere for almost like $400.
Yeah, I saw someone doing that, but like price. A first-person shooter, right?
Yeah.
Like they're running and getting behind cover and like shooting and right. stuff.
Like cool I could that? Only imagine playing like Farpoint for the PSVR or even, what is it? Damn, I'm forgetting the name. It's like the strike game or whatever. It's the gun game at Firewall. Firewall 0 Hour. So that one is like that's real in depth, you know, in there playing that game. I could only imagine if you could actually physically move in that game and you're really moving and you're sitting there and aiming, that game would be like superb.
Yeah.
And I've seen these treadmills, and these treadmills are, I think, rounding about $400 to $500.
Wow, I'm surprised they're that cheap.
And they already work with the game systems. So, you know, I mean, I've been like, you know, looking at them and kind of like, you know, seeing if I can, if it's like doable. So, I mean, if there's like a really great game that comes out for the PSVR, I mean, one of the ones that I will be looking into is
Medal of Honor or what?
No. Well, I did want the Medal of Honor because we talked about that a few podcasts ago. But No Man's Sky is coming to VR.
That sounds cool.
And they've changed the game a lot.
Yeah.
So I could only imagine how great it would be if I could get an actual, like, you know, good view in my VR headset, you know, good, you know, quality in my headset, and then be able to roam around like that. So, I mean, definitely the treadmill is like on my list of things that I want to get. You know,
that's the
you
next
just
step,
have to,
you know, that's the next step.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, there's like the really huge ones, and then there's like they're trying to perfect the compactness. You know what I mean? Like they have how to do it, so now they're just trying to figure out how to make it compact so that it can fit in your living room and not take up a crap load of space. You know what I mean? Because you gotta have something that is able to hold you and keep you, you know, stationary while you sit there and sprint.
Dude,
and
you'd be so
I can
tired.
Only imagine.
Oh my gosh.
But it'd be real.
One match
you know what
would
I mean?
Be like so tiring.
Like I can only imagine like all of the, you know, no offense, but the fatties that are sitting there and then they have to play like this VR game and you have to move, like you shed mad pounds, man.
No, it'd
there.
Be cool.
Like
I was going to
really
mention.
If you really run and you could keep that speed going, there's no stamina. Your stamina is the stamina
dude,
for the run. That's awesome,
that would be cool, actually.
That's so funny, dude.
There's, no the longer do I have to wait for the stamina bar to come back.
Your water meter is your internal water meter.
You're
like, I'm thirsty.
It's a real survival. You got a snack table next to you. So you can
no,
just
like, how cool would it be, too, like, if they had, like, a calorie counter, right? So, like, you see, like...
So you can see
it.
Yeah,
like, how much you actually burn that day, right?
So, like, okay, so Beat Saber is a great game for the VR headset, whatever you play.
The one you're doing like this, right?
Yeah. Like, it's the best things. On, like, Quest, because you can actually move around and maneuver, you know? But when you're playing with the PSVR headset, you got to worry about that damn cord in the back of you.
Right.
But, like, Beat Saber has modes on it that say, like calorie burning mode or, you know, other, like, it's an exercise. Mm-hmm. Like, you would think, like, oh, it's not that bad. You know, you're just twirling your arms around.
You're
dude.
Burning,
but if you do
huh?
that for, like, you're 20,
burning.
30 minutes, man, yeah, you sweating.
Yeah.
Like, you piping hot after you get done playing, you know? So, there's a lot that's there with the VR, but you just got to get games to put time into it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you already have a first person, you know, Cyberpunk, if you just made it so that it's portable to the VR headset and you can do everything that's in the game, but it can acknowledge your fingers moving when you go to touch something, when you, you know, when you get in the car, you know what I mean? You can do different things in the car, whatever. And it's the full game. There's nothing less. That's a sell. It's gotta be. Like, who wouldn't want to actually play it in first person? Like, yeah, you're playing it in first person, but to actually play it in first person.
No, that was
where you
always
can hang your
head out the window and you can shoot.
You know what I mean?
That
and
was always
real.
The problem from VR from the start was that we knew, well, we hoped that you would just be able to play your PlayStation games on it.
Right.
Come to find out, no, it's like a whole separate kind of thing that has its specific own games.
Yeah.
And that immediately, like, you know, like,
and I mean,
the hype on it.
I've used the VR headset before just to play a regular game, but you're in like theater mode,
right?
So it's like this screen surrounded by a bunch of blackness, you know what I mean? And it's convenient when somebody else is using TV, but it's not what I was looking for. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I wanted that VR experience. Yeah. And if they're able to do, you know, like get the LiDAR going and have all this, the sensors and everything that you'll be able to, it'll be able to really track your movement, you know, and positioning and all that stuff, man, that's just, it's going to be amazing. Like, I think it really just takes like that one game or like, you know, like four or five games that people like really enjoy regular to just make a port for the VR. Like say, hey, it's able to be played on the PSVR. And it's mind blowing. Like you've already played the game, but check it out in VR. You know what I mean?
I love gaming.